How's it going, guys? Welcome to an absolute beginner's electric guitar lesson. But if you saw my video that I uploaded yesterday, you'll know what's coming. I'm going to be demoing everything that I do in this video with my non-dominant hand. I'm going to be doing this left-handed. Now, why on earth would I do such a thing? Well, I've uploaded many beginner easy riffs and many absolute beginner guitar lessons over the last 10 years here on YouTube. And what I want to offer is a new perspective, especially on electric guitar, because frankly, electric guitar offers so many more options, even as an absolute beginner, to play, but those things maybe aren't as easy to cover in your standard beginner's guitar lesson. I wanted to put myself in the shoes of an absolute beginner and show you what can be physically playable, even to an absolute beginner. I have not been practicing playing guitar left-handed. This is something that I'm wanting to do totally afresh to show you guys what you can expect when you're trying out electric guitar riffs and trying to play anything on electric guitar. As a total beginner, I'm putting myself in your shoes. If you would like to grab your guitar and join me, I'd love you to play along with me with your electric guitar. The one thing we need to know, though, is how to get your guitar in tune. That video is just up here. You can use any number of free guitar apps, but if you need my video on it teaching you how to get your guitar in tune, that's the video that you need. Let's make a start. So first things first, even on electric guitar, the same things still apply that we did in the previous video where I covered how to do this on acoustic guitar and demoing things left-handed. Here's the E major and then the A major, and learning a few easy songs with just the E, A, and then the D chord. But once those E and A are learnt, there's our D chord just there. And let's see how this sounds. That's the D. That's the A. And that's the E. I've got to that level by just drilling the changes between each of those, so E to then to the A, E then the A, and of course I'm aware of how to strumming time and that kind of thing. All those basics need to be learned just by strumming easy songs, and I really recommend that you check out that first video and then perhaps my free 10-day starter course, which is kind of designed for acoustic guitar, but we need all those same principles even if you want to rock out and play electric guitar. However, once you have got E, A, and D major under your fingers, there's a couple of really fun things that we can do on electric guitar, even if you haven't done any of that. Just kind of get the buzz going, show you the possibilities, and keep you playing guitar, because it's such a fun thing. There's so many things open for us. And a couple of those things are power chords, and this is an easy, this is basically the E major chord, but just playable with one finger. But to do that, we just play the thickest two strings. Straight away, that has a little bit of overdrive on my sound. I'm using an amplifier and I'm on the overdrive channel, but that makes it sound like this. And that is a really great sound. That's the reason a lot of people want to be able to play electric guitar, to kind of get that sound. And then we can play that same thing, but a string down. Sometimes I would move my thumb over the top, because we've got to be very careful which strings we pick. I'm only picking string 5 and 4. But that's the E5 and the A5, the easy two power chords. And that's where we start with my electric guitar starter course, which is an offshoot of my main guitar syllabus, which just shows you all these kind of extra things where you can get playing guitar straight away, with all the other cool things that are really electric guitar specific and kind of rock guitar specific as well. We can do that same thing on the D as well, though it's a little bit trickier because we've got to find just the middle two strings. And then with those three chords, we can play a lot of riffs, but the riffs tend to be all about playing chords and changing chords well, recreating the rhythm of the riff, and then muting, so being able to play a chord and tame the beast. We've got to, especially with some electric guitar overdrive on it. That muting becomes everything. That's a very different approach to if we're typically playing kind of beginner acoustic guitar songs. So that's a very electric guitar specific thing. What else can we go for? Well, we've hopefully learned the E, D, and A major chords by now, the full way of playing those chords. So it's well worth learning a couple of easy riffs with those chords. One of my favorites would be I Can't Explain by The Who. This one's a little bit trickier because there's a bit more to it, but let me give this a go. That is a song by The Who, which are one of my favourite bands, that you can even play as an absolute beginner. Now, of course, as I've previously said, there are things that I know because I play guitar and I'm a musician about rhythm and timing. I know how that song goes already. I've taught it many times. And just learning the physical skill of playing these chords left-handed, I can get a result a lot quicker than I might expect any beginner to do. So the biggest thing is just keep playing 15 minutes a day or 10 minutes a day just to get these chords under your fingers. If you want to practice more than that and longer than that, have a little break because it's still going to be leaving lines in your fingers and it's going to be painful for your fingertips. Though I will say it's not nearly as painful to play electric guitar, even as a beginner, as it is acoustic guitar. Acoustic guitar is going to leave bigger lines in your fingers and be much harder to play, frankly, it has to be said. A lot of people want to play acoustic guitar and that's fine, but electric guitar is more forgiving. The overdrive can mask certain things. It can make chord changes seem not too bad, and especially when we have a lot of rock riffs that kind of have this muting idea. Kind of play those chords pretty badly then, but the overdrive makes it okay. It's something to really be aware of. Another great riff. I don't think that we would do this with muting really, but this would be Wild Thing by the Troggs. So I'm going to leave all that in because I don't want you guys to think I'm just editing this and you know, just showing the good times I play. Let me figure this one out. This one is tougher. So A. I'll mute it so you can hear me clearly. D, 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 Wild Thing. You make my heart sing. And that is the pure joy of electric guitar, playing a short, recognisable riff that other people will recognise, that sounds like something to you. It cannot be understated how cool that is. Now, a lot of other classic riffs are kind of a lot harder, but there are easier ways to do them. One example of this is Smoke on the Water, which can be a little tough the proper way to do it. And the easier way that I teach it, or always used to teach it, even to people that had never even held a guitar before, and once you've learned this, you can jam it along to the original recording as well, is just by plucking the middle two strings like this, and then going from the open to third fret to fifth fret. Something like that. That at least sounds something like recognizable, even though I've only played it once before, and we kind of explored this idea on my side project, which is called Another Guitar Show, where we sort of did a lot more on this topic and other things that beginners can do. Check it out if you're interested in learning a bit more about this. And then, of course, the riff that I demoed in my acoustic guitar video that I just uploaded yesterday. This would be Satisfaction by the Rolling Stones, which does sound a lot more like it on electric guitar, or hopefully it will. Okay, so we had other strings ringing out then. This is really important. Did you hear kind of just kind of really lightly, like the strings ringing out as I was playing? What I would do if I was playing electric guitar is I'd have my little finger, if I was playing it with my, you know, the proper way around, the way that I learned, is have my little finger on the outside of my palm kind of dampening those thinner strings so that we'd always... I'm using improper kind of technique there. It's not perfect, but that's the kind of thing that I'd be doing, which is all what I call kind of taming the beast of electric guitar. If we let go of the strings, we straight away get some noise, and we've got to learn to dampen those strings right down. And I will say, you know, from having a go at this left-handed, it is a real education, because you suddenly see why a lot of the videos I've done where we're learning riffs on one string, specifically electric guitar riffs, are suddenly quite doable, even some of the trickier ones, maybe something like... 20th Century Boy, that's hopefully something like recognisable. And even things like Seven Nation Army on One String are doable as a beginner. And as soon as we go over, like, between strings, it's really, really difficult. Like, the difficulty becomes 10 times as hard when you're not used to doing it. It becomes easier if you play guitar a little bit every day, but it's a really important thing to know that go easy on yourself and learn these riffs, learn things that are recognisable, especially if you're learning electric guitar. It will make a lot of difference, and you can always revisit certain riffs that are perhaps your favourite and try and learn them more accurate to the record later. But don't put that pressure on yourself in the first week. Try and use proper technique. A couple of things to note on technique. We're having the thumb lower than most beginners would. A lot of beginners like to kind of hold things like this. We're going to be staying right on the tips of our fingers. That's the other thing that I'm doing, keeping that thumb lower. Keeping the elbow in at all times just tends to really help us be on the right kind of angle. I'm not tensing up too much, and I'm not... Here's a thing that I noticed when I first started playing. So I'd kind of press down on a string. This is me pressing down now, just how I normally would. And then if I press down harder, the actual note bends up so much further. It's kind of crazy, just by pressing down too hard. So that's normal. I'm just gonna press down harder. Straight away, really noticeable, and that would throw your guitar entirely out of tune. So a lot of my students, a lot of pupils would have what I call a sort of nickname, gorilla grip. They'd be holding the guitar way too, pressing down too hard and holding the thing for dear life. And not only does that mean that you can't play as fast, it can actually knock you out of tune so easy. And just even easy things sound very bad, because even if we play this E chord, that's it normal. And then if I press down hard, I kind of knock it out of tuning, and I'm not bending the neck back or anything. I'm just pressing that string down too hard. Something to really be aware of. And if this is the sort of thing that you're after, those things that we can just get the most bang for your buck for, something where you can just start playing easy guitar riffs straight away and make the most and learn these little tricks that we have to do that are electric guitar specific, highly recommend that you check out my electric guitar starter course. Half of it is for free on YouTube, and the rest is available on the website at andyguitar.co.uk, and also on Android on the Andy Guitar app. It's only available on Android at the moment, I'm sorry, but the iOS one is coming, I promise you. And that will get you started with some free backing tracks, getting you jamming along to it. But don't discount, although we've had a lot of fun in this lesson, I hope, and there's some cool things that I've shown you, don't discount just strumming some easy three chord songs, because we need those skills of learning how to play on the beat and just being able to play guitar along to the song for a couple of minutes, just to get the foundations of music and guitar under your fingers, make this feel a lot more comfortable, and then you'll be able to learn a lot more riffs and your progress will be rapid from there. If you follow those principles, I promise you. Check out that electric guitar starter course and the other things that I offer here on YouTube. I hope to see you in another video of mine. Take care of yourselves. Bye for now.